morning. Today we're out here at Jenkins Custom Homes Design Center. We're going to be insulating the structure today. We're going to walk you through how we're doing it, why we're doing it, and why it's the best practice. Due to the efficient nature of the design of the building, we've decided to use spray foam as our insulation. We've decided to use spray foam in this building because it's a superior sealing product, where standard insulation may settle and create voids over time, allowing air pockets and thus moisture to enter the building. A spray foam product seals the cavity completely. First, let's talk about this spray foam insulation. It's a two-part mixed material, equal parts of this blue A and red B. They're put under pressure and pumped over to these reactors. The reactors heat them up to about 125, 130 degrees, depending on the ambient outside air temperature that day. Then each of the lines are still kept separate, but they're heated all the way from the reactor all the way to the nozzle. They're not mixed until they come out of the nozzle at approximately 125 degrees. The two heated elements are then pumped to the end of the gun, and at the nozzle in the end of the gun, the materials are mixed together and sprayed into the cavity. A chemical reaction then takes place that causes gas to form in between the mixture, causing millions and millions of air bubbles. As the material dries or cures, the walls to those little bubbles burst, and that's what creates the open cell form, where a closed cell form of foam, those little bubbles don't burst as they dry. And the reason that the open cell foam is better on this particular application, because if there is any water infiltration into the cavities, the open cell foam will allow that water to drain out, not trapping it in the wall, causing mold and other issues. As they're spraying the foam, they use a gauge to make sure that we've got the correct thickness, since after a while, some areas it's not as easy to see.